In this problem, we're taking a value of atmospheric pressure that's 101.3 kilopascals, and we're asked to convert this to pounds per square inch, which is also known as a PSI. And we're told the following conversions might be useful. First, you need to know that a pascal is actually a newton per square meter. Then we have a conversion between newtons and pounds. And then we have a conversion between inches and centimeters. And the first thing I'm going to write down here is that 101.3 kilopascals is the same as 101,300 pascals. Just getting rid of that kilo prefix, which means 1,000. And at the same time, I'm going to replace pascals with newtons per square meter. I want to convert those square meters to square centimeters. And I can do that with this conversion factor, 1 meter for every 100 centimeters. The thing you have to be really careful about here is that I need 2 copies of that conversion factor to cancel both factors of meters, and that will leave me with centimeters squared in the denominator. Then I need to convert those square centimeters to square inches. And I use this conversion factor, 2.54 centimeters for every inch. And again, I have 2 copies of centimeters. So to cancel those, I need to square that conversion factor. And finally, it looks like I need to convert the newtons to pounds. So 1 newton is 0.225 pounds. After smashing all these numbers together in a calculator, so taking 101,300 times 2.54 squared times 0.225, and then dividing by 100 squared, I get 14.7. And my surviving units here, after those newtons are gone, are pounds in the numerator and inches squared in the denominator. So this is pounds per square inch, which normally is written as PSI. So there's our atmospheric pressure in PSI, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.